Well, good evening, everybody. This is Pastor Gloria. I want to welcome you all to my channel, all 122 of you, and also to my Periscope, my Periscope family too. Today's date is October the 8th of 2016. This is Pastor Gloria, and the number 8 represents Jesus. It represents Jesus. Now, I was taking a drink of water earlier, and I got a little strangled. So if I may have to be clearing my throat. I don't know. And again, I cannot get this focused right. If I don't want to scoot way back, and then I'd have to holler, and yell and everything. I don't want to do that. So, anyway, I haven't did one for my YouTube family for a while anyway, but this will be for my YouTube family and my Periscope family, like I said a while ago. And we all love Jesus, right? We all love Jesus. And the Lord is bringing us all together in one mind and one accord. But it's very important. We have to get things right. And being in the unity of Christ is the right thing, right? That's the right thing, is being in the unity of Christ. And first of all, I want to do the Lord's Prayer. Let's do the Lord's Prayer. Okay. Our Heavenly Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. But lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen and amen. And they all said, amen. Like I said, I was going to go on Periscope a while ago, but my connection was too poor. And maybe I was supposed to do an actual video on my YouTube channel. And again, I love you all, one and all. My YouTube family and my Periscope family all joined in one, as one, in the body of Christ. And I don't want to have any misunderstandings when it comes to Jesus and when it comes to God's Word. We have to understand spiritually. There are some denominations that says that some things that's in the Bible is symbolic, it isn't literal. And I know one denomination feels that way, and that is the Adventists feel that way. And some people still believe that the end times were from way back, all them centuries ago. And when he gave his life on the cross, when he said it was finished, it was finished. And I want to say something else too. I don't know everything. I am still learning. I'm learning too. I didn't know 2 years ago that God was going to call me to be his disciple, to be his minister. I didn't know that. I had thought maybe that I might carry on my dad's musical part of the ministry, but not me being an actual minister. And again, I will say, I'm learning too. But I know what is right. And I was advised, I was told not to look at God's Word, to look through the spiritual eyes and not through the flesh. I have prayed about it. And I'm going to ask you all too, to pray about this. Because there are so many people that can get things, I'm tangled up here, that can get things twisted. Not meaning to, not even knowing it, that can get things twisted. And when the Bible says something, when the Lord speaks through the Bible, it's not symbolic. It is literal. It is literal. And I pray in Jesus' precious holy name that the people that are having little doubts as to if some of that is symbolic or not, that the Holy Spirit will witness, that will witness to you, whoever it may be. I know beyond a shadow of a doubt that what I read in my God's holy word, this is very important. We cannot mess around with something like this because it is too important. I'm going to say this again. Out of love, and it makes me want to cry. We are in the last days before Jesus returns. I'm saying this out of love, and I'm saying this because I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, as God and the Holy Spirit is my witness. We are in the end times. And I've said this before. Look at everything that's going around. Look at everything that's going on in this world today. And people say that things are getting better. Spiritually, yes. There has been a major rising up of the saints. Yes, that part is true. The Lord is bringing us all together in one mind and one accord. Yes, that's true. But all the evil things that's going on, we can't overlook all that. And everything, look at the flood. Look at the hurricane that hit Florida and other states. It's one of the Bible prophecies, and other people says that the Bible prophecies have already happened years, centuries ago, that the Bible prophecies have already been fulfilled. No, that is not correct. And it was suggested to me to read Matthew 24 again, Matthew 24:38. I will. I'm going to get into the Bible here in a few minutes, and I'm going to read those scriptures. But I am a true woman of God. One of these nights, if I can do it without breaking down, one of these nights I'm going to get on here and I'm going to talk about my earthly dad. My earthly dad. He only had a sixth grade education. My daddy couldn't read or write. God taught him. All he wanted to do was preach God's word. That's all he wanted to do is preach God's word. Once he got saved, he wanted God to teach him to read and to write and to read, be able to read the word. He had the discernment of spirits. He had the gift of knowledge. He had all the gifts. He was just as near a saint on this earth as anybody that I ever knew or ever had the privilege of knowing. And me and him being my earthly daddy. It was told to me by I don't know how many people that he was a very special man. A very special man. And I love my dad dearly. And I know I will see him again. But it is an honor. I tend to go in circles. But it is an honor to know that God has handed down the mantle from my daddy to me. It is an honor and a privilege. And I know that my dad and my mother both would be very proud to know that Gloria is carrying on her dad's ministry. And I'm very humbled. I'm very, very humbled. And I'm going to say this to you all again, too. You can bet whatever I tell you is the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth. In spirit and in truth. In spirit and in truth. I don't know how long this video is going to be. I haven't had my snack yet tonight. I don't know how long this is going to be. But in these End times. Yes, end times. Please, people, wake up. Please. Listen to Sister Gloria, Pastor Gloria. Listen to what I'm saying to you. Listen through the Spirit. The Holy Spirit will make intercession to you all to let you know that it is true. The Bible prophecies have not been fulfilled. They have not been fulfilled. I love you all so very much. It's like the 90 and the 9, that one lost sheep. The Lord would go after that one lost sheep to bring back to the fold, to bring back. And I think most of you know, and I've said this before, but I think most of you know, if you have the discernment, you know that I'm real. I'm not a fake. I love my Lord very much. I love my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, very much. He gave his life on that cross. He bore our sins on that cross, on the old rugged cross. So to get on to something else, there was a comment left on my video that I did, the last video I did. There was a comment left on there, and I couldn't get it. I don't know whether somebody deleted it out. The person said something about, thank you for sharing. I can't remember, just part of it. And then when I went to the, under the video, it was on my notifications. And then when I went on to the video, to the comments, I only had 3 on there. And the person that commented went by USE, a space, then capital VT. So I don't know what you said. I would appreciate it if you would comment again, because I couldn't get it all. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know if somebody went in there and deleted it out. I don't know. Because as you know, we all will be attacked. We all will be attacked by the devil. We will all have attacks. If I keep looking off to the side, I've taken little notes. So I'm going to get into the Bible. I'm going to get into the Word here in a few minutes. And again, I love you very much. Hang on just a minute. I watched a video earlier. She's called Reverend Mary. I don't know if she's one of my subscribers or not. I don't know. But she said that she had a song on her mind the last few days. Where could I go but to the Lord? That used to be one of my favorite songs. And I don't know if it's in my songbook. It's not listed under that name, but under that title. Where could I... Might help me turn it on first. Where could I go, seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend to save me in the end. Where could I go but to the Lord? And I don't know what the song is titled in my songbook. I don't know. I remember singing that song in church. I love you all. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there. None other has ever known. He speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet. The birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart is ringing. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there. None other has ever known. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I give you all the honor and the glory and your praise. In your precious, precious holy name I pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Okay. Just wanted to do that. Couple. Hang on just a second, people. I had to turn my light out. We're up to 17 minutes already. It's just, it really gets to me, though. It really gets to me. There is so much division. There's a lot of division in the body of Christ. And there shouldn't be. Even though he is bringing us all into one body, I mean one mind and one accord, yes, but there is still division. So many different beliefs, so many different denominations, man-made denominations that God never intended. So now I'm going to get into the Holy Word. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence. Substance is hoped for and evidence of things unseen or something like that. I forget how it goes. This is my word, people. This is my word. Oh, I always do that backwards. I always do it backwards. This is my word. My holy word. And we don't idolize the Bible. The Bible was left to teach. Maybe there has been some scriptures left out. Maybe there's been some added to. I don't know. But I do know that the King James Version is the one that we're supposed to go by. The King James Version. All right, now let's speed this up a little bit now, because we're up to almost 20 minutes, so I'm going to kind of speed this up a little bit. I love you all. All right, I'm going to read Exodus 14:14. Exodus 14:14. Hang on just a minute. You know how these pages want to stick, people, so bear with me. That's right, I'm on I'm on my YouTube. My YouTube 14. Bear with me, people. I get down to the last page and then it wants to stick. All right. Exodus 14:14, verse 14. All right. All right. Hang on just a minute. Hang on just a second. I'm going to read verses 13. I'm going to start from verses 13 of Exodus 14. And Moses said unto the people, Fear ye not, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show to you today, for the Egyptians whom ye have seen today, ye shall see them again no more forever. 14. The Lord shall fight for you, and ye shall hold your peace. You shall hold your peace. This is speaking about Moses. The Lord said unto Moses, Wherefore criest thou unto me, speaking to the children of Israel, that they go forward? Okay. All right. Just something stirring in my spirit, people. Something stirring in my spirit. I don't know what it is yet, but I'm about to find out. 1 John 2:18. 1 John 2:18. 1 John 2:18. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Something stirring in my spirit. Something stirring. All right. I just came to 2 Timothy chapter 3. 2 Timothy chapter 3, and I read this not too long ago. 2 Timothy chapter 3, hang on just a second. You know how it works with me sometimes when I get to reading, and then certain ones will jump out? All right, here we go. 2 Timothy chapter 3. This know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. What are we going through now? Praise God, hallelujah. What are we going through now? Ask yourselves this. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with divers lusts, ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, hallelujah. Oshalaka teka ola shala teka ola shala teka ola la teka la mo ola shateka la shateka la osa teka la mo. The Lord's making intercession with me right now to a few of you out there. His Holy Spirit is all over me. His Holy Spirit is all over me. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. My, 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 my. Now as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so did these also resist the truth. Men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith. Turning to reprobate minds concerning the faith. But they shall proceed no further, for their folly shall be manifest unto all men as theirs also was. But thou hast fully known my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, charity, patience. Charity means love. Patience. Persecutions, afflictions, which came unto me at Antioch and Iconium and Lystra, which what persecutions I endured, but out of them all the Lord delivered me. Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. What have I been talking about? What have I been talking about? This is a mighty word. This is like a trumpet being sounded. This is a mighty word. Praise God, hallelujah. My, 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 my. Yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them. And that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures as a child, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise my holy Savior, hallelujah. That the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Chapter 4, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing at his kingdom. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. Praise God, hallelujah. But after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears. Having itching ears. The ministers that just preaches just to hear, you know, what people want to hear. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itchy ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth. They shall turn away their ears from the truth. And shall be turned into fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry, make full proof of thy ministry, preach the word, preach the word. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto them also that loved his appearance. Do thy diligence to come shortly unto me. My, 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 my. All right, I'm going to go down to verse 17 of 2 Timothy chapter 3. I think it was chapter 3. Verse 17. Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, that by that by me the preaching might be fully known, and that all the Gentiles might hear, and I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. And the Lord shall, this is Paul, Paul's son in faith, and the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work, and will preserve me into his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. My. I love this. Verse 14. But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned, that hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. It makes me almost want to cry. All scripture is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, and the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. I could read this over and over and over and over. This is a mighty word. You know, I told you earlier that something wasn't right. I felt a stirring in me. So what did he do? I was turning back over to Matthew. I was going to read Matthew. And I came to 2 Timothy chapter 3. Now there's a reason for that. I'm a woman of God. I am a woman of God. Heart, mind, body, and soul. A woman that's not perfect. And I don't claim to be perfect. I never have claimed to be perfect. Because we all still sin and fall short of the glory of God. And we won't be perfect until we take on the incorruptible. When we leave these corruptible bodies and be changed in the twinkling of an eye, when the Lord comes, when that trumpet sounds. This is a mighty word, people. I just read a mighty word from God, and through his holy word. Wake up. The Lord says to wake up. Stay the course. Praise God, hallelujah. Pray, stay the course. If we faint not, we will endure till the end. We will endure to the end. We must keep preaching the truth. And this holy word is the truth. This is a mighty word. I'm not calling anybody out. Not at all. This is a mighty word for a lot of people. A lot of people. 33 minutes. 33 is a divine number. 33 is a divine number. Where could I go? Where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul. Needing a friend to save me in the end. Where could I go but to the Lord? Yes. Where could we go but to the Lord? I love you all, people. I love you all. That shook me to the core. That shook me to the core when he had me to read that. Why would he have me to read that? This word is not symbolic. It is literal. God inspired men to write these words. I love you all. Oh shaka take ala sha take ala shala take ala oma ola take ola oh Elohim 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 Oshalakateka ola teka ola mate kalasate kalasala tekala almaza katekalasale katalamo. Oshalatekalashate kalasate kalamo. I love you, Jesus. I pray right now, Lord, to those that hears the sound of my voice on here, I pray that your Holy Spirit, that the Holy Ghost will touch them, will touch people, will touch them, dear Jesus, that your comforter that you sent when you went away, that your comforter, the Holy Ghost, will come upon people and slay them in the spirit. Literally slay them in the spirit. Fill them up, Jesus. Fill them up. Fill them with your holy word. Fill them with your holy word, Jesus. And I give you the honor and the glory and the praise in your precious, precious holy name, I pray. And you know something, people? Yes, the gifts are free. The gifts are free. But it's God who gives the gifts. We pray, we ask the Lord for the gifts. But it's up to Him. Like Sister Judy Levi says, it's up to Him to give us the gifts. He is to be praised. He is worthy of our praise. He's worthy to be praised. To worship him. Our beloved Savior, our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. He's worthy to be praised. And I'll say this again, there's none righteous. No, not one. There's none righteous. And I'm just a vessel. I'm just a woman that loves Him, getting His word out. Getting the word out. Because when that trumpet sounds and He comes through them clouds, no one can dispute what I just read. Like I said, it's not symbolic. It is the literal word. Why would the Lord have me to read that? Why? So if anybody doubts what Sister Gloria, what Pastor Gloria is saying, pray about it. We're already up now to over 38 minutes. I didn't want to make this video too long. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I love you all. So until my next video, and to all of you on Periscope that have joined my channel, I love you all, one and all. And again, to all of my 122 subscribers, God bless you. Come back to my channel. You're always welcome to my channel. Please leave me comments. Feel free to leave me comments. And USEVT. The one that I didn't get to read, I don't know what happened to it. And it's now about 9:30, so I better get my snack and get ready to go. So I'm going to close in prayer. When I kneel in prayer, I hope to meet you there. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand, for I need Thee every hour. Mm-hmm. Protect me by thy path. Oh Lord, look down on me. When I kneel in prayer, I hope to meet you there. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Yes, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. But lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen and amen. And they all said, amen. I love you. I love you all. Pastor Gloria loves you all. And something else too about, I'm not trying to exalt myself. That was mentioned to me a while back too. I am on here to glorify and edify my Lord and my Savior Jesus Christ, not Gloria Harlow Drummond. No. It's all about Jesus. It's all about my love for Jesus. Okay.